Hey y'all, it's Erica, and I'm here today to do a review of Drown by Junot, Díaz. This is a collection of short stories, and it's a book mainly about the Dominican immigrant experience into the U.S. And I feel like this is important, especially now. I know on BookTube there are a lot of more people talking about trying to read more diversely and read more books by people of color. And so I felt like this would be a good review to do to talk about this, because if you haven't read anything by Junot, Díaz, he is a wonderful writer on the immigrant experience, and I highly recommend his work. This is only the second book I've read by him, actually. The first one is the ever-famous The Brief Wondrous Life of Oscar Wilde, which actually won a Pulitzer and is an incredible book. But I wanted to delve into some of his lesser-known works, which is this, and then after this I'm going to read This Is How You Lose Her. I originally read one of the stories from this book, which is called Negocios, for a Latino-Latina lit class that I took in college as part of my degree. And I studied both English and English literature, and I studied Spanish in college. So the Latino literature is very close to my heart. I have worked locally with some nonprofit organizations that work with immigrant issues in the area. And I live in an area that's highly populated by Hispanic immigrants. I also work in a restaurant, so I work with a lot of Mexican and Central American immigrants. So the immigrant experience and the Latino experience is something that I'm very interested in reading about. Junot, Díaz is a Latino writer. His family is from the Dominican Republic, and he writes a lot on that topic. If you've ever read The Brief Wondrous Life of Oscar Wilde, you know that. So I really enjoyed these stories. Interwoven stories about basically an immigrant boy. You see him at different stages of his life. You see him when he is a young child, still living in the Dominican Republic, and waiting for his dad to come back from the United States to come get their family, because his dad had immigrated to the United States ahead of time to try and make enough money to get the family to the United States as well. So you see him in that setting. You see him in the Dominican Republic, living in a third world country, amidst a lot of poverty and bad influences, with no real education. Then you kind of see him grow up, and you hear about his life in urban New Jersey, which also, if you've read The Brief Wondrous Life of Oscar Wilde, takes place in a similar setting. And so you get to see how maybe the American dream didn't quite come true for this family, and how he gets into a lot of, you know, drug dealing, and is still surrounded by bad influences, though of a different sort. I felt like the main overarching themes of this book obviously had to do with family and the sacrifices you make for one's family. There's a lot about how his dad wasn't faithful to his mom, and there's a lot about how he doesn't treat the family very well, but how they kind of react to that, and how the mom and the kids bond together in the face of that. There's also obviously a lot about the immigrant experience, and about being a stranger in a strange place. I really like Junot, Díaz's take on racial relations, and especially in, you know, more urban areas, where he can talk about, you know, how it's not just whites against people of color, but how in an urban area there's you know, subgroups where even among the Hispanic community there are breaks, and there are prejudices between maybe people from the Caribbean and people from Mexico and things like that, which I think is really interesting to learn about. So you see a lot of that, and you see the narrators coping with these sort of stereotypes about their lives. I thought the writing in this book was absolutely amazing. There's one line that like really tugged at me, and I think it is, the line was, the narrator in the specific story was talking about a breakup with a girlfriend, and he said something to the effect of, no amount of heart leather could keep something like that from hurting. And I thought that was really beautiful. I think the writing is very smart. It's pretty gritty. Junot, Díaz, he doesn't beat about the bush. He doesn't romanticize the immigrant experience. So this, I would definitely say, is a gritty novel. But I definitely recommend it, especially for anyone who's interested in learning more about the Latino experience, this is a great place to start. If you are a fan of short stories, I think Junot Díaz is an amazing short story writer. I mean, some of these stories were a little bit longer, you know, 30 pages or so, but a couple of them were only a few pages long, and I always admire a short story writer who can pack a punch in so few words, and he can definitely do that. This is quite a short collection. It's just over 200 pages long. It's really easy to get through. It's very, you know, enthralling. And if you have any questions or want to learn more about it, let me know. But again, this is Drowned by Junot Díaz, and I gave this book 4 out of 5 stars on Goodreads, and I definitely recommend it. Thank you all so much, and have a good day.